Welcome to KELA's Let's Talk About It. Discussions on a variety of topics of interest to Southwest Washington area listeners. Write down our listener call-in number and keep it handy. 330-5352. That's 330-KELA. You're invited to join in with your calls now at 330-KELA. Views expressed on this show are those of the host, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or advertisers. Daily programs are recorded for playback, podcasts, and promotional purposes. And now, let's talk about it.
Good morning, and welcome back to the Let's Talk About It show on AM 1470 KELA. I'm your host, Peter Abbarno, for part two of the candidate interview and Q&A. And yesterday, we had a whole show we talked to, but we played our interviews with Diane Dory, who is running for Centralia Port Commissioner, Julie Balmelli Powell, who's running for Chehalis School Board, Kelly Smith Johnston with Centralia City Council, Linda Godovac with Tenino Mayor, Mandy McDougall with Centralia School Board, Mike Morrow with the Rochester School Board, and Peter Lamont also running for Centralia Port. And today we have a whole nother lineup of great candidates who are going to be talking about why you should vote for them, because ballots were in the mail yesterday and today and this week. So you might even get them soon. You should get them soon. If you don't, go to sos.wa.gov. You can check out where your ballot is, your status of your ballot. You can register to vote. You can find out where your drop-off are. But we're going to start off with Russell Barr. Russell is running for Centralia City Council. He was at the Chamber of Commerce debate earlier this month and has been in the community for a while and wants to talk about why you should vote for him. So up next, Russell Barr, Centralia City Council.
My name's Russell Barr, and I'm running for Centralia City Council, position one at large. I arrived in Centralia about 35 years ago as a young man, and have lived here ever since, and have watched the city go through many changes, and I don't see the pace of those changes slowing down anytime soon. I've worked in the private and public sector, worked for the school district, Twin Transit, and currently, for the last 20 years, been working for a software company that makes software for the public sector, for local governments.
If you're elected as a member of the Centralia City Council, what is the top issue you'd like to address in your term?
I see crime as the top issue facing Centralia, at least among issues that can be addressed by Centralia City Council. I don't see that the City Council can directly affect homelessness, for example, which is a large problem, but that's something that is being driven by national and state policies and issues that we can only make the smallest dent in here through our local government. So again, I see crime as our top issue and the thing we need to focus on to keep Centralia a good place to live and work.
As gas prices reach the highest in the nation and cost of living increases continue to place stress on families, how can you as a city councilor help improve the city's quality of life and economic vitality?
Gas prices are not the only thing that are nearing their peak these days, but gas prices are also not something that we can directly address at the city level. We don't take much taxes in gas. There's also real estate and food and commodity prices that are also very high that we have limited control over at the local level. What we do have control over is our city streets and sidewalks and keeping them safe and crime-free. I think that addressing the issues of crime in Centralia is very important to make it inviting for people to live here, as well as people having jobs to come to live in Centralia and to stay here. So we need family wage jobs in town, which the city can encourage over time. The council can encourage businesses to locate here, and we can also support the police in keeping our streets and sidewalks safe so that people want to stay.
Okay, that was Russell Barr with the Centralia City. He's running for Centralia City Council, and you know, these candidates aren't hand-picked by KELA-KMNT. They actually, all the candidates get emails and get reached out to by the station, because we get this question all the time. Did you invite this person? Did you invite? But that, yeah, absolutely. Everyone gets invited. And if you respond and you come and you record, you get on the air. And if you don't, you don't. So that was Russell Barr. And, you know, we want to make sure that we provide opportunities for candidates. This is a yearly thing. And sometimes candidates participate and others don't. But it's always good to hear. And it's good for the listeners to hear what the vision is for many of these candidates. And a lot of them are challengers. Some of them are going to be incumbents. But these recordings, yesterday's recording of the candidates that I outlined before, and this set of candidates today are going to be run again. Now, they're all going to be shared on social media and links, and you can share them with your friends so you can continue to learn more about these candidates. But Let's Talk About It Sunday is a show I host every Sunday. It's at 7:30 in the morning on KELA before Shannon Bream and Fox News, and then again at 11 p.m. on KMNT, and they also stream at KELAAM.com and KMNT.com. So you could always follow that up. And aside from the candidate interviews, I record shows every Sunday from national. Last week, I think I had the American Edge Project, which is a national organization talking about technological innovation, to local issues. And so be sure to make sure you tune in, because if you miss this show, we're going to be sharing it again. Up next is Sarah Holmes. Sarah is running for the Centralia School Board. And like many other incumbents as well as challengers, has talked a lot about pushing back on Olympia. Some of the policies coming down and the Office of Superintendent of Public Instruction and trying to promote more parental involvement. And that's what Sarah's been talking about, like many of the, not only the challengers on school boards, but the incumbents. So let's listen to Sarah Holmes.
My name is Sarah Holmes, and I am running for Centralia School Board, Position 4. I was born and raised right here in Lewis County and graduated from Onalaska High School. I received my associate degree in medical administration from Centralia College and am working towards my bachelor's degree in elementary education. My husband Shane and I have been married 18 years and run a family business together, Westside Waste and Water. Our two kids, Savannah 14 and Hudson 7, go to Centralia Schools. We are vested in this community and volunteer and sponsor whenever we get the opportunity. We love watching our kids play sports and coaching. You will find us on the fields or courts usually. Our family is also active in the Pacific Northwest lifestyle. We enjoy hiking, fishing, hunting, beach combing, camping, and really anything outdoors.
If you're elected to the Centralia School Board, what would be the top issue you'd like to address?
The top issue I would like to address of being elected as a school board member is hands down safety. Ensuring the safety of our students and staff has always been my top priority, because none of the other aspects of education matter if students and staff do not feel safe in their environment. When you walk through those doors at your school, feeling safe should be a non-negotiable. This is a bare minimum to be able to teach or learn successfully. We can achieve this goal with firm and effective policies and procedures, such as having a student resource officer in every school. I will be focusing on not only student accountability, but also parent accountability. It's crucial that our students aren't missing out on learning time for the negative actions and behaviors of other students.
With some communities finding it difficult to pass levies and bonds, how do you address the need for school and student funding?
With Centralia's levy failures looming in the background, I think it's necessary to be humble and address the issues within. The first step to solving a problem is to identify the problem. It's clear that people in our community have various grievances, including concerns about safety, transparency, budget constraints, and the presence of certain ideologies in the classrooms. If the district could better reflect the values of the community, it would likely garner more support for our schools. There is a large body of people who feel their voices are not being heard. The role of the school board is to ensure that the district is responsive and representative of the values, beliefs, and priorities of the community. I believe our community wants to support our schools, and they will, with strong leadership, fiscal responsibility, transparency, and safety in place. It's time to earn back trust with accountability and good decision making.
All right, and that was Sarah Holmes. She's running for the Centralia School Board in the Centralia School District. And as a reminder, ballots are coming out. Ballots get mailed on October 20th, and that's the start of the 18-day voting period. October 30th is when online and mail registrations must be received, which is 8 days before Election Day. The deadline for Washington State voter registrations or any updates in person is Election Day, November 7th. And then obviously, maybe not obviously, the election is on November 7th. And as a reminder, we talked about this at the last candidate interview forum part one, is that only about 40% of Washingtonians vote in these elections. So it's super important that that you turn out. If you look around the room and you see 10 people, six of them are not going to vote. Maybe you're one of those people who don't vote in these types of quote-unquote off-year elections. So you're letting the minority of people, 40%, dictate how your community is going to go. So be sure to turn out. Make sure you return your ballot. Make sure you deliver your ballot to a box or mail it. And make sure you vote. It's so important. Well, up next is Susie Hawes. Susie Hawes is running for the Rochester School Board. Susie is a lifelong supporter of Rochester, active volunteer in the community, raised a family in Rochester School District. She's sharing her story and reasons why you should cast your vote. And if you live in the Rochester School District, Susie Hawes is someone that you want to consider voting for. So up next, Susie Hawes, Rochester School Board.
My name is Susie Hawes, and I'm running for the Rochester School Board Director, Position 3. I moved to Rochester in 1979 and raised 7 children, all who graduated from Rochester High School. 6 of my grandchildren have also graduated from Rochester. I'm running for school board because I am deeply invested in my community. My daughter and my grandson are teachers, so I'm aware of the challenges that our teachers face today, and I am motivated to support them. That being said, I also recognize that parents are very frustrated with the direction that our schools have gone. I believe that our schools need to reflect our local values, and parents must be the foremost decision makers in their child's education. I am passionate about raising academic standards for all Rochester students and will work hard to achieve this. When elected, I will ensure that parents are heard and that teachers are supported.
If you're elected to the Rochester School Board, what's the top issue you'd like to address?
My passion is academics. At present time, Rochester has a critical academic shortfall. I feel it is very important to bring Rochester School District academics up to a level that allows our graduates to be successful in work, community, and life. Currently, Rochester academic outcomes translate to a D across all subjects, reading, writing, math, and science. These low outcomes are unacceptable. We can do better. We must be laser focused on the goal of educating our students in the basics. We have to prepare our students to compete in this quickly changing world. It is clear that whether the student is college bound, looking at trade schools, or preparing for other careers, a solid educational foundation is critical for their future.
With some school districts finding it difficult to pass levies and bonds, how would you address the need for school and student funding?
I have talked to many community members and parents, and I keep hearing that academics is an area of great concern and one of their top priorities. Levies are passed to help with learning. For example, levy dollars can be used to reduce class size by hiring more teachers, which directly improves academic outcomes. Bonds are for buildings. This is important because as our community keeps growing, more classrooms and space is needed. The goal is to keep class sizes smaller, allowing students better access to learning, which directly improves academic outcomes as well. Both levies and bonds are critical funds paid for by the community. Therefore, community members need to be engaged with how those tax dollars are spent in our schools. I believe that careful planning and transparency in all areas is the key to working with our community to improve our schools.
All right, so that was Susie Hawes running for the Rochester School Board. You heard from Russell Barr earlier today. He's running for the Centralia City Council. You heard from Sarah Holmes, who is running for the Centralia School Board. And now you just heard from Susie Hawes, who's also running for the Rochester School Board. And there's kind of that theme with school board members regarding parents. I mean, I'm a parent, and most certainly I want to be reached out to and engaged within your school district. And, you know, the education of your children, there's few things more important than that. And it's clear that parents really want more involvement in that. And that's not always just the local school board. That's sometimes the Office of Superintendent of Public Instruction in Olympia who passes things and adopts things that really hamstrung a lot of school districts over the last few years. You know, a reminder, if you don't already have your ballot, I mean, ballots were mailed out October 20th, which is today. And that's the start of the 18-day voting period. If you're having trouble with your ballot, whether you're in Thurston or Lewis, you can reach out to your county auditor, or you can go to sos.wa.gov. There's an election tab that you can click on, which not only provides you information and deadlines on your ballot, where it is, you know, what's going on, but you can request one. You can find out where you can drop it off. You get a little bit more information. You can get the voter's pamphlet. If you didn't receive one, you can go look at one. So they're online as well. So we're going to take a quick break for our sponsors, and then we're going to be back. We have 3 more candidates that we're going to listen to regarding what they want vision for. As some of it's in Rochester, some of it's all of Thurston County. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.
it's your local real estate professional, Heather Stewart with Blade Realty. With the changing real estate market, you may be thinking of sitting on the sidelines this quarter, but it's really a super time to stay in the game with buyer competition slowing and more inventory on the market. Now more than ever, you'll need that trusted resource with a proven reputation and track record to help you win in real estate. I'd love to be on your team. For stellar service in your real estate ventures, find me, Heather Stewart Realtor, on Facebook or at heatherstewartrealtor.com.
What is Emporium Ayala? It's a shopping experience. A 14,000 square foot antique mall. Antique and vintage furniture, curated home decor, vinyl, vintage jewelry and memorabilia. With a broad assortment of ever-changing inventory, unique items you won't find anywhere else. The only thing that remains the same is our low prices. Emporium Ayala, at the corner of North Tower and Magnolia in downtown Centralia. And at EmporiumAyala.com. Find us on Facebook and Instagram.
Solar. Solar for Lewis and Thurston counties. Chehalo Sheet Metal is now doing solar and electrical. Great savings on all your residential solar needs. Whether it's heating, cooling, or roofing, CSM has you covered. Call today, 360-748-9221. Get your home comfort project done before winter hits. Chehalo Sheet Metal is there for all your needs. Did we mention we do solar? Call Chehalo Sheet Metal. Schedule your free solar appointment now. 360-748-9221.
Save the date. The KMNT KELA Fall Radio Auction, brought to you by the Power Shop Centralia, is coming up on Saturday, October 21st, beginning at 8 a.m. You can save a ton of money with instant items and your winning bid on goods and services from local participating businesses. The Fall Radio Auction, coming up Saturday, October 21st, on both AM 1470 and 104.3 FM, and online at KELAAM.com. and KMNT.com.
It's on my phone, online. I'm listening all the time.
KELA.
Let's talk about it.
Welcome back to Let's Talk About It, AM 1470 KELA and KELAAM.com. I'm your host, Peter Barno, with another edition of the Candidates Interview and Q&A. Always fun. We heard from Russell Barr, Sarah Holmes, Susie Hawes. We've got three more candidates. And, you know, listening to the advertisement for Emporium Ayala is a reminder, too, that KELA-KMNT is going to be at the Lighted Tractor Parade in downtown Centralia on December 9th. And we have the KELA-KMNT stage where we play music before the parade, and then I get to announce the parade, which I've done probably for now 7 or 8 years, maybe longer. It feels like longer. Sometimes in very dry, cold weather. Sometimes it's nice, and sometimes it's raining. But you know what is consistent, even if the weather's not? There are tons of people that come out for the Lighted Tractor Parade. So we're always there. The parade starts at 6. We're always there an hour or so ahead of time playing music, giving away free prizes, and make sure you come visit us. And, you know, if you're a sponsor and you want to get a shout out, make sure you contact the radio station. We'd love to have you there too. So, all right, up next, we've got Wava Garza. Garza is running for the Rochester School Board and wants to know why you should cast your ballot in the Rochester School Board race for them. And here's their statement and their Q&A. And you had already heard actually from Susie Hawes from the Rochester School Board. And yesterday we had heard from Michael Morrow, who also is running for the Rochester School Board. So three responded, and this is the next.
My name is Wava Garza, and I am a candidate for the Rochester School Board as the District 2 Director. I believe the primary function of a school board director is to work cooperatively with parents, the community, and administrators to establish the most suitable policies and guidelines that advance the mission of helping our children be successful in public school. I will work hard for students to receive the most excellent school education for every tax dollar spent. I will work to make informed decisions and be accountable for those decisions. I will be curious to ask why. I will strive for the knowledge to ask, are you sure? And I will seek the courage to question if this is right and good.
If you were elected to the Rochester School Board, what is the top issue you'd like to address?
The school district is facing a budget shortfall. Soon, there will not be enough funds to pay for all expenses. This will mean hard decisions regarding budget cuts and how best to use the limited financial resources of the school district. Budget cuts are hard on a school district. Staff fear losing their jobs, and they fear losing resources they have come to depend on for teaching. I hope to use our resources to focus on achievable, measurable academic goals, and I invite and urge the community to come forth with all ideas and concerns regarding budget cuts. My door will be open.
With some school districts finding it difficult to pass levies and bonds, how do you address the need for school and student funding?
School districts run levies to enhance education. Reducing class size and maximizing instructional time spent with students are great benefits to children and a good use of levy tax dollars. Levies fail because community members are disheartened with the school's spending priorities and with poor academic outcomes. They don't feel as though they are getting a return on their hard-earned tax dollars. We need to keep our priorities on academic learning, and that requires community support. If elected, I plan to engage the community in fiscal responsibility and have their voices heard about where their tax dollars are spent.
All right, that was Wava Garza running for Rochester School Board. Telling you why she wants to earn your vote in the upcoming election. Again, ballots out or starting to be out mailed October 20th, start of the 18-day voting period. And obviously go to sos.wa.gov. If you have additional questions about the deadlines, you can register and update your voter ID on November 7th. I shouldn't said voter ID because that'll start a whole thing, even though you probably might, should, can have a voter ID. Some countries do, we don't. But you can do it in person. And then obviously election day is November 7th. So you can turn your ballot in, mail it in, drop it in a drop box, and then go to sos.wa.gov. And you can actually track it. You can make sure that if there's an issue with your ballot, you might know in advance. Now up next, Vivian Eason. Vivian is running for Thurston County Commissioner. She did very well in the primary and is asking for your vote now in the general. She's been around Thurston County advocating for taxpayers and landowners, and you can listen to her story and vision for Thurston County right now.
Hi, my name is Vivian Eason. I'm running for Thurston County Commissioner District 4. District 4 is a new county commissioner position that covers South Thurston County, including my area where I live is Rochester, Washington, and I've lived out there since 2003. I have spent 35 years working for Thurston County, 15 of those working for the Sheriff's Department, and then 15 of my last years was working with Thurston County Emergency Management in countywide program of education for emergency management. My goals for Thurston County is to increase staffing for our Thurston County Sheriff's Department. I want to focus on affordable housing, balancing property rights, and protecting the environment. I also want to prioritize neighborhood and school safety and develop reforms to reduce the drug and mental health crisis. I want to reduce county planning barriers that hinder local business growth.
If you're elected to the Thurston County Commission, what is the top issue you'd like to address?
You know, it's really hard to pick a top issue, but public safety is one of my number one priorities. We have a tax initiative that's going to appear on the ballot in November that gives 0.2%, which would go to help fund our Sheriff's Department. It actually is a countywide tax that would give 60% to the county, 40% to the municipalities, and it would also help to fund the prosecutor's office, public defense, some security for elections, but it would help us to bring our public safety and the Sheriff's Department up. We're second to the lowest funded per capita in the state of Washington. And so as a person who lives in unincorporated Thurston County, that's huge for us because that is our main line of public safety, and that's who responds for accidents, for calls when we make 911, for protecting our areas out there. And so I really have a true passion for improving the safety, not just for the citizens, but for our deputy sheriffs who are out on the road, and so that they are able to get back up when they need that.
As gas prices reach the highest in the nation and cost of living increases continue to stress families, how can you as a county commissioner help relieve the tax burden?
As a county commissioner, we do not control gas tax. But there are other taxes that we can look at, ways that we can reduce our spending in the county. I know revenue has flatlined. We are looking at reduction in the county budget, but we have to think about how we can support the community in other ways, getting some grants down to some of the nonprofits that help people that are needing food, you know, utilizing other ways to help our communities, working with our nonprofits, working with our other community partners on just some transparency between us and the citizens on how we can better serve them without raising taxes.
All right. That was Vivian Eason. She is running for Thurston County Commissioner in a newly created Thurston County Commissioner seat. And her opponent in the election, also a candidate, is Wayne Fournier. Wayne is currently the mayor of Tenino and a firefighter. He wants to take his, you know, direction of Tenino and the energy for Tenino and actually spread it out throughout South Thurston County and representing this brand new county seat. Let's hear from Wayne. And I've worked with Wayne on a number of different things, just like Linda Godovac earlier in the candidate questionnaire and interview part one, on a lot of things like the pump track and some other things going on in the city of Tenino. So this is another good candidate for Thurston County Commissioner, Wayne Fournier.
Hi, my name is Wayne Fournier, and I'm running to be your next Thurston County Commissioner. I have the experience to hit the ground running on day one. As mayor of Tenino, we've successfully reinvigorated our city's commercial environments, fixed its failing infrastructure, doubled the city's budget, and gone from failing to thriving. As a firefighter and a father, I know that public safety is not only about cops on the road, it also includes emergency systems and infrastructure, adequate housing and support services for people in crisis, behavioral health and chemical dependency treatment, and robust environmental and public health protections. We must bring these systems together to make Thurston County the safest place to raise our family. As a leader, I'm proud to have the endorsements of people from across both parties, including Representative Peter Abbarno and Representative Beth Dolio. They see me as an effective leader, and it doesn't matter what party I choose.
If you're elected to the Thurston County Commission, what is the top issue you'd like to address?
Effective government, continue technology upgrades, and other efficiencies that cut expenses, reducing needs for new tax increases.
As gas prices reach the highest in the nation and cost of living increases continue to stress families, how can you as a county commissioner help relieve the tax burden?
We need to invest in key programs and projects that will attract and create new higher wage jobs. I want to fight to increase the share of local revenue from marijuana taxes. The Washington State Liquor Control Board gets the lion's share, and way too little of the excise tax makes it back to the jurisdictions it came from. This could mean millions of dollars in new local revenue that is already being collected.
All right. That was Wayne Fournier. You'd heard from. All right. So part one of the candidate interview was Diane Dory running for Centralia Port, Julie Balmelli Poe running for Shale School Board, Kelly Smith Johnson for the Centralia City Council, Linda Godovac, Tenino Mayor, Mandy McDougall, Centralia School Board, Michael Morrow with the Rochester School Board, Peter Lamont, Centralia Port, Russell Barr. Now, today we heard from Russell Barr, Centralia City Council, Sarah Holmes, Centralia School District School Board, Susie Hawes, Rochester School Board, Wava Garza, Rochester School Board, Wayne Fournier for Thurston County Commission, and then you heard from Vivian Eason, also running for the Thurston County Commission. So we're going to be rerunning part one and part two on our Let's Talk About It Sunday show, which airs at 7:30 in the morning on Sunday on KELA right before Fox News with Shannon Bream. It also runs at 11 p.m. on KMNT 104.3. So it's going to run on AM and FM. And you're also going to be able to hear it by streaming KELAAM.com and KMNT.com. And then once these air, we're going to be also posting them on social media, the links that you can share with your friends. And just remember, October 20th is the day when the start of the 18-day voting period is. October 30th, online and mail registrations must be received 8 days before Election Day. November 7th is Election Day, and that's the deadline for Washington State voter registrations or updates, and it's in-person only. So it's important. Look, only 40% historically vote in these elections, and they have a huge impact on our quality of life, kitchen table issues, the things that are going on in our daily lives. whether it's transportation, whether it's crime, whether it's property tax increases, a lot of that happens at the local level, your kids' education, and it starts at the local level. So get involved, make sure you register to vote if you're not already and turn in your ballot. Thanks for listening. Let's talk about it with your host, me, Peter Abbarno.
Stay informed.